Good day, everybody. Thanks so much for clicking play and checking out the weather with me. My name is Jewel, and this is J7409 Weather, along with the Tropical Update. Getting right on with it, here is Hurricane Delta. Boy, in just a few hours after yesterday's video, winds picked up by yesterday afternoon to 100 miles per hour. Right now, the winds are 110 miles per hour. That's only 1 mile per hour shy of being a Category 3. I expect Delta to become a Cat 3 at some point this afternoon or tonight, and by tomorrow morning, probably before lunchtime or thereabouts, a Category 4. Now, I'm going to have more on Delta coming up, but let's go check out what is happening first in the lower 48. As we take a look at the NAM map, this is what should occur over the next few days. It's courtesy of Tropical Tidbit. I'll turn it on, let it roll right quickly. It's looking like mainly tranquil weather is for most of the nation through early Thursday. Then, of course, we have Hurricane Delta. It's intensifying over the western Caribbean and headed towards the Gulf of Mexico. But weather in general for the lower 48, relatively quiet. It's a quiet pattern. There's no severe thunderstorm activity of any type that should occur today. And it's looking like pleasant autumn weather for much of the eastern half of the U.S. and little in the way of rainfall from the plains to the mid-Atlantic region. Now, showers are likely across portions of the northeast because a cold front is going to cross the region Wednesday, tomorrow, but rainfall amounts are expected to be under an inch. Now, also, it's going to continue to be dry for the western U.S. and the western high plains, except above normal temperatures are expected to continue as the upper level ridge continues to hold strong over the region. Widespread highs in the 80s and 90s are expected. In addition, the air quality alerts in effect for portions of California and Oregon and Colorado is beginning to die just a little for the smoke from the ongoing wildfire. Still, many, many watches and warnings are up. Gulf Coast region, next couple of days, you're going to be uneventful also, but by the end of the week, Friday and Saturday, possibly Thursday night, we're going to have to keep our eyes on Delta. Right quickly, if you haven't subscribed and you're into the weather, please subscribe. I would appreciate it very much. Click that bell and make sure you check off all. If you don't check off all, you won't get all of my videos as I put them out. That's a YouTube thing. Okay, I told you guys earlier, a few days ago, I was going to show you some more models. This is the HWRF, intensification with wind speed. This is the entire model for the HWRF model. Now, I'm going to click it down just a bit so you can see this is winds. The bar here shows you the color of the winds. Here we are right up in here. You can see right in this area here, we're going to click it through one stage at a time. This is still today. You can see today how it is intensifying. See this orange right in here, right around the center of circulation. Well, we've got 114 mile per hour winds at this point. Okay, we'll keep on clicking through. We're still on the 6. Now we're at midnight. You can see it is still intensifying more and more. We'll just move it on across here. It stays very, very strong. Possibly even Category 4 winds coming up in here, looking like by tomorrow as it moves along. It goes across the Yucatan right here It should lose a little strength, a little bit, but then it's going to well right back up. Now, when it comes across this area here, what it's going to do is it's in, going to be in a very moist area. No wind, no wind shear at all. And it's going to absorb some of this moisture from gamma. And by the way, gamma is gone this morning. It's just a little old low. It's nothing to worry about. You can see as it goes across, this is where gamma was located in this area. Yesterday, what was left of gamma, it's, well, delta's going to pick up all of the moisture from it. Now, as we continue to move across, you can see the intensification isn't going down any at all, hardly. Then it starts to. Look at where it is on a big map where you can see it. It's up in this area. It may encounter some shear wind at this time. Still a category 2. As it moves along, it starts to intensify more again. As you see the little orange area here peak up, moving back up in intensity and growing, as you can see. So we're going to have to keep our eyes on this. You can see there's Louisiana, there's Texas. This is a very powerful storm at this point. Please, folks, pay attention to what is going on. You can see here is Delta on the satellite this morning, right here. Everybody on the island areas over here, I know you see all of these cloud tops. This is just rain. You're going to be getting some rain. We'll turn this on, let it move through a little bit. You can see how Delta, though, by the cloud top intensity on the satellite, is just taking off in intensity. Taking off in intensity. So, once again, everybody down here, this is just a pressure system, a wave going through. The wind should not be bad, but you will get rain. But everybody look out over in this area. Now, it's looking like it's going to go up. It could come landfall as a very high-end category 2 or possibly a 3. 3 is major. Even if it is a high-end category 2 when it makes landfall, don't let that deceive you. This is a very powerful storm. And when it reaches 3, and I'm pretty sure it's going to reach a 4 before it's all over. That's what all indications are looking like now. Of course, this could change, but either way, it's going to have a very big storm surge with it. It's been rotating out in the Gulf of Mexico. It's upwelling water. It's going to make for storm surge. You're going to have storm surge. You're going to have winds. You're going to have rain. It's going to be a mess. Let's go check out the National Hurricane Center. And here we are with the latest report from the National Hurricane Center. The winds are 110 miles per hour. The minimum central pressure is 962 millibars. It's located at 17.8 north, 82.0 west. It's moving west northwest around 15 miles per hour. And as you can see, gamma is gone. No other systems are out here now. This is a 2-day. You can put it on the 5-day. There's nothing else out here right now except this wave that is going across the island chain here, bringing lots of rain. As we take a look at the tracking map from the National Hurricane Center, you can see Tuesday morning at 8, it's right here, and it is, like I said, probably more than likely becoming a major hurricane today as a Cat 3, staying this way, but it's going to go up and down in intensity. It's going to remain a major hurricane, possibly could be a Cat 4, and I'm not going to rule out possibility at a some slight point of a Cat 5. But I'm going to stick with a Cat 4 right now, or a very end Cat 3, as it goes across this little area of the Yucatan Peninsula here. You can see the hurricane warnings are already up. Wherever you see the blue on the western edge of Cuba, down here, everything in blue is a tropical storm warning. And just a little bit south of where this tropical storm warning in Cuba ends, it is a tropical storm watch. But folks, we have tropical storm warnings also down around these areas. Hurricane warning right in this area. You can see it's going to remain a major hurricane till at least Friday. Then what might happen? We may have some wind shear up here, just enough to knock it down to a high-end Category 2. That's what the National Hurricane Center is forecasting at this time. It's still too early to tell, though, folks. This is just what it's looking like as of today. Anyone in these areas, we'll try to bring this map down just a little bit here. Anywhere in these portions of Louisiana, and we still, Texas is just in the cone now. They were not in the cone yesterday. The National Hurricane Center has shifted it a little more to the west, as I expected they might. We're going to have to wait and see. Anywhere in this cone area, from Florida, and I'm going to say over to Texas, this is the most likely. It can shift, though. Many things can happen. Everyone, please keep your eyes on this and stay aware. Once again, click Show More down below this video. I'll have all the watches and warnings posted there. Looking to me like this storm is going to hit late Friday or possibly Saturday, early morning when it comes inland. This is what it's looking like now, and the National Hurricane Center is also agreeing with this at this time. Here is the latest satellite from the National Hurricane Center. As you can see, I'd like to stress, extremely dangerous storm surge and hurricane conditions are expected within portions of the northern Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico beginning tonight. If you're in those areas, and I just showed you, the hurricane warning is in effect. Heavy rain. The rain is going to affect portions of the Cayman Islands, western Cuba, and northern Yucatan Peninsula through midweek. Now, this rainfall could lead to flash flooding and mudslides, and the potential for heavy rain and flash flooding will increase across portions of the central Gulf Coast, Tennessee Valley, and southeastern United States as Delta moves inland, probably late Friday or early Saturday morning. Now, it's looking like Delta should approach the northern Gulf Coast late week as a hurricane. A Category 2, at least, could be a 3, but a very high-end 2 is looking like that's certain. Now, there is a little uncertainty in the track and intensity when you put all the models together, but there is a significant risk of dangerous storm surge, wind, and rainfall hazards along the coast from Louisiana to the western Florida panhandle beginning Thursday night or Friday. And everybody in these areas should ensure that they have their hurricane plan in place and monitor all of your local weather updates, all of whatever your local authorities may tell you when it comes to Delta. Because Delta looks like she's going to prove to be a very significant storm. We have a quick look now, right quick, as we wind this up this morning. This is the GFS map. We will go over to the European map. This is the wind field, as you can see, looking like coming in right in this area. New Orleans to the right of it, you know, everything over here usually gets the brunt of the storm moving up. If we'll flip over right quick to the European model, it's not quite in the same place at this time as we go over. See, it's a little further over here. And it looks like the intensity is down to a Category 2. It's a little further over here. That's why I'm saying Texas, just don't let your guard down. Keep up with this. Keep up with this. This is around 1 a.m. on Saturday morning. This is the European model here. It has it over here where the GFS model, as we flip back to it, has it over here and more intensified. We're going to have to keep our eyes on it. We'll flip over a little bit to around 6 a.m. and we see on the GFS it is moving up and out in this way. We'll go to the European model right quick and let's see where it has it. It has it coming in over in this area with winds beginning to affect Texas. Still too early to tell exactly where it's going to land. I would say anywhere from Florida to the slight edges of Texas, the eastern sections of Texas, and especially Louisiana, Mississippi. You guys, everybody in these areas, please, please, can't stress enough, pay attention. Get all of your local weather forecast. Make sure if your local authorities tell you to do anything to abide by it. Because even if it is a high end 2, the storm surge is going to be great. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Thank you so much for watching and everything you do for me. May each and every one of you have much peace, love, and kindness in your life today. Thank you for watching.